Did you know that a new pseudo-class is coming to CSS that will let you easily target all headings on your page? Do you know how to easily create text styles where a color fades to transparency gradually? And most importantly, do you know why you shouldn't add box sizing border box to your CSS reset? Find out all about this and more in the next few minutes. This episode is sponsored by Rocket. More on why you should use this amazing vibe coding tool in a minute. First up, I want to show you Heading, a new pseudo-class that is coming to browsers hopefully fairly soon. It allows you to select with one pseudo-class all heading elements on your page. This allows you to very easily style those without having to add extra selectors like matching h1, h2, h3, h4. All you need to do is set Heading pseudo-class and you can style all headings on your page immediately. This feature is experimental and only available at the moment in Firefox Nightly, and that behind the flag. So if you want to play with it, you will first need to enable it. To do that, you're gonna open About Config page in Firefox. We're gonna proceed here. We're gonna search for heading. There it is. Layout CSS heading selector enabled needs to be set to true. I already enabled it before, so I don't have to change anything here. But if you enable it, you will probably need to restart your browser before you can actually use it. Let's try it out. I'm gonna go back to this page and I'm gonna open my developer tools. Let's target all heading elements with the heading pseudo class. And as you can see, this is crossed out here. Apparently it's still not fully supported in developer tools in Firefox, but it will work. So I will set color here, for example, to yellow. And as you can see, all headings on this page, H1, H2, H3, and so on, are styled with just this one pseudo-class. Another thing to know about the heading pseudo-class is that it has the same specificity as a class. This means that by default, it will overwrite all your heading selectors as H1, H2, and so on. Of course, this is still experimental, not supported in any browsers other than Firefox and Nightly, so you cannot use this right now, but hopefully we'll see browsers implemented soon, and this will enable you then to easily style all your headings immediately. Would you like to see this feature implemented in other browsers, and would you actually use it? Let me know in the comments. This week's sponsor is Rocket, the world's most advanced vibe coding tool. It allows you to describe in one sentence what you want to build, from landing pages to dashboards with real-time logic to portfolios and more. Rocket can build it for you. I'm not gonna just talk about it. I will show you on an example how great it actually is. Let's try following. Create a one-page personal portfolio website that showcases my development projects with pure HTML and CSS based on my GitHub profile. Once you hit enter, you will get this beautiful interface that shows you step-by-step what Rocket exactly is doing. This is actually interactive and it will let you participate in the decision-making process. Let's do homepage, developer portfolio, single-page application. That's gonna be great. Build my website. It will take a few minutes for this to finish, but once it's done, you're gonna be able to see preview of this website right here. You can use it as a starting point for your new developer portfolio that showcases your skills and your projects. This is how simple it is to get started with Rocket. So hit the link in the description and check out Rocket today. You will get free credits that you can use to build your very first project. Thanks so much to Rocket for sponsoring. Next up, Cassidy Williams shows a simple CSS trick that will help you create faded text effects. The first solution that Cassidy shows is using span elements around the letters to target every letter specifically and change opacity. But of course, there is a better, nicer, more elegant solution using pure CSS where you set color to transparent, background to linear gradient that goes from a certain color to transparent color, and then set the background clip to text. In my opinion, this is a much better solution than the one where you have to target every letter specifically and change their opacities. But as an alternative, you can use CSS to create a nice fading effect. Let me quickly show you how this works. I'm gonna copy the snippet. I'm gonna open the landing page for my new newsletter, AI Developer, focused on AI trends in development world. If you're still not subscribed, then hit the link below and subscribe today. And I'm gonna show you exactly how the faded text effect works on this headline. I'll open developer tools, I'll target this heading, and I'll paste in the snippet. This snippet is using hex and RGBA color formats, and I don't really like those, so I'm gonna quickly switch those and developer tools to HSL format, and this one as well. There we go, so now I can very easily turn this to white. Lightness is gonna be 100%, and this one as well should be light 100% with transparency of 10. I think this fades a little bit too much, so I'm gonna set it to something like 30%. This is still visible, but I think it's a little bit better. And now only the second row of my text is faded out. If I want to have the entire heading fade out gradually, I'm gonna need to set this to display block or display inline block. Let's try display block, for example. And now the entire heading will be faded out. But of course, I will need to tweak it a little bit more. For example, let's set it to bottom right. And let's start the gradient not from 80%, but rather from 40%, maybe even less, 20%. Now the entire heading is nicely faded out. This effect is, of course, much more prominent if you have a pattern in the background or some kind of an image. But if you ever want to create text that fades to transparency, this is how you should do it. Of course, read the Cassidy's article yourself and check out the other solution where each letter is faded separately. Next up, Miriam Suzanne explains why you shouldn't add box sizing border box to your CSS resets or normalizes. This is, according to Miriam, an outdated practice, and Miriam lists a number of disadvantages if you do that, or rather, Miriam specifically outlines the advantages of content box model for box sizing. Those are specifically related to content, as the content box keyword actually specifies as well. For example, if you want to set a text to certain length, to certain length of characters, because the ideal length for reading is between 60 and 85 characters or something like that. If you want to do that, then you want to exclude the padding from this size, meaning that you don't want border box, but you actually want the box sizing content box. And of course, Miriam explains more in detail about disadvantages of actually using border box when it comes to inheritance specifically and more. This is a good reminder that best practices are changing with time. Something that might have been a best practice before might actually have a better solution today, or actually it wasn't even the best practice in the first place. Next up, Jason Santa Maria created a really nice page that demonstrates the power of quotes when it comes to typography. As developers, we mostly use straight quotes. I'm guilty of that as well. These straight quotes that you can usually see on the web are actually called dumb quotes. They are a legacy from typewriters, because at that time it was not really possible to create smart quotes like we have here, when the first quote is turned in this direction, the second one in this direction, which looks really nice. It's more readable. Jason Santa Maria, of course, in this article on this page, explains exactly why you should be using smart quotes and shows a nice cheat sheet that will show you how to use them on your OS or even as entities in web development. So if you want your text to look good, to be more readable, stop using straight quotes and start using smart quotes. This is exactly how you should be using them. Last up, we have a fantastic collection of demos created by Adam Argyle that showcases the power of view transitions. View transitions, as you probably know, allow you to transition or morph certain states of your website smoothly into entirely different states. In this demo, for example, this is the animation that happens when you're using any of the elements on the page here. They're nicely transitioned, flipped, and turned into this dialogue. Adam created a ton of examples here, and you should check them out all just to get an idea of what is possible using view transitions and how simple it is to create those. But another one that I want to highlight here is this one, a gallery where images transition from the sidebar to the main stage. I'm going to click on those. As you can see, this is really smooth, really elegant, and it's actually very easy to create this. There are a few lines of JavaScript here. This function handles click events. If view transitions are not supported by the browser, then we want to use a different form of transitioning. But if they are, then essentially a few lines of code will enable you to create something as beautiful and effective as this. And as CSS is concerned, this is fairly simple as well. We have a view transition group and a number of view transitions on every item of the gallery. Those are created manually right here. All in all, setup is pretty simple, and it clearly demonstrates how powerful view transitions actually are. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different view transition, or rather, in the next video.